dealt with a situation this serious. I think you might be dead. Spanky, calm down. Spanky, look at me. I need you to compose yourself right now, damn it. I need you to be as cool as you've ever been before. As cool as sliding brass knuckles into me. Because we're dealing with a situation right here. This man.
I can't believe you. Don't you die on us.
This man taught me how to walk. We've got to save this man, and we've got to put all our heads together to do it.
I'm sorry.
Boys.
I'm sorry.
Keep it together.
He taught me how to love a woman.
What? He said he taught him how to love a woman, and I highly doubt that. Even if he did.
The girl's goddamn baby.
Even if he did, he taught you how to do it to too many of them. Now.
Okay, boy. I got an idea. I'll call Stan.
Legal jargon is not going to help us.
I'm going to call Stan.
We need a doctor.
Oh, God.
No.
Tom. Mm.
You can't. No. You're not setting it up.
My mistake. Wait.
Hold. Look at him. Boys, he's still alive.
Oh, my God.
He's breathing. Thank God
we ain't got to pay the funeral bill.
We got to get him a mode of transportation. Coach. You two get his feet. We'll get his arms.
Oh, my God.
You secure his head.
Look a bug.
I'll get his legs.
Get his legs. We'll get his arms.
I love you so much.
Come on.
I'm sorry.
We got to get him to a doctor.
I got his middle.
Dr. Tom.
Dr. Tom. The best doctor.
You got a cigarette?
I don't smoke, but no. I'm sorry.
I don't either.
Hey. I don't, no cigarettes, but I got the hard stuff. Here you go, Nate Jake.
Good God. Okay. What was that?
Sprite Zero.
Oh.
I don't like
spray. All right. Now that the silverback's getting lubed up, boys, I think it's time that we, after these harrowing couple of days, talk about the...
incident?
No, not just the incident, but...
I'm sorry!
It's okay. It's not your fault. Nobody blames you. Spanky! Pull it together. Listen, we have to talk about the implications of what went down last Wednesday. Yes, everyone has seen now that Coach Dan Winkle was wrongfully...
Absolutely.
Was a wrongful casualty of war. Sorry, Nick Jake.
Okay.
Was a wrongful casualty of war in the plight of the SSC. But now we must talk about, and you two are going to help me, and you're going to put that 10 back in your wallet.
That's all he had in there.
Oh, he pulled out a 20.
Oh, wow.
But you two are going to help me talk about how we are going to move on without him. The SSC has not operated without Coach Dan Winkle since our fourth episode.
I got it.
How are we going to move on without him?
I've got it. I quit.
No, you sit down. Don't you get out of that chair. Put those sunglasses back on. You toughen up. And you give me an idea as to how the hell we're going to get through this. I have a solution, do you?
I don't know.
Okay, I got it. I do have it this time.
Do you?
We're going to cut a pair of Stan's lawyer pants. We're going to take one of his button-ups. We're going to slice the sleeves. We're going to buy him a visor, probably a plaid one. Looks like something you could wear in court. We'll just pretend.
It ain't the same, damn it!
What everyone is failing to account for is he was my best friend since second grade.
He was there when I was born!
He was there when I made love!
And I am having to be the rock where the rest of you have not stopped crying for a week!
I'm emotional! I've had an emotional week besides this!
His belt side plate was upside down.
Oh,
poor
my
baby!
God.
Nate Jake, cut to...
I can't handle
this. Cut to the one of the thousands of video messages sent by our lovely viewers for Coach Dan Winkle. Cut to that, please.
Howdy, folks. No joke. Sonny Poke here. And come to y'all with a heavy heart. I got the news today. A dear friend of mine, Coach Dan Winkle, Little Winky, as I call him, my Little Winky, he's passed on. He's left this world. And me and Little Winky, we go way back. I met him last year, I think. And, you know, Little Winky, you didn't teach me much, but what you did teach me, I'll never forget. So I'm coming to Coalfield, not only to whoop some ass, but to raise a glass for Winky. I'll see you soon.
Here's to you. No joke, Johnny Poke, thank you for that address. The SSC values you greatly, and all of the people that have sent messages to Coach Dan Winkle, and boys, well, you two have been crying in the breast milk all week. I've read a lot of books.
I got breasts.
Shut up. I've read a lot of books. A lot of books on grieving. And in these books, it says that you are supposed to not shy away from anything the parted party has done for you. So I think we should talk about some memories of Coach Dan Winkle. I think it will bring us closer together, and I think it will get us through this time. Who would like to start?
First one that comes to mind is I was struggling really bad in third grade with social studies. Just really, really bad. And I didn't think I was going to make an A, and I was an all-A student my whole life. And I go to the coach. I said, Coach, I just don't understand the American Revolution. I just didn't get it. Why would you turn on England? I just didn't understand at the time. I wasn't young enough to...
They were doing a lot for us.
...grasp the freedom that we needed.
I was trying to figure out the color of the third grade.
Yes, you were, Spanky. Yes, you were.
I flipped in the book to page 87, and I look, and it's George Washington crossing the Delaware, and all of a sudden, my soul sparked. Third passenger from the left. Rowing that boat so George could go to glory. There's he single-handedly defeated the British, and from that point forward, I've been as patriotic as you can get.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Coach Dan Winkle, for your service.
Spanky, do you have anything?
I remember all the times that he would yell at me and tell me to go and run.
It's my favorite scene in SSC history.
It's a lot of people's.
But I remember the times that were not filmed. The times that, he would get all personal and lovey with me. And the times that he would say he loved me.
Hang on to those, Spank.
Hang on to those. Because he never said it to him, but I know he meant it.
Well, that was not as constructive as you were hoping for.
No, it was not, but
he
like
told
I
me,
said,
he never told me 1-4-3.
He told me every day.
Like I said, it's good not to shy away from the bad parts as well as the good parts.
And I don't think it looks Spanky.
I have a lot of memories with Coach Dan Winkle, be that as it may. I'm sorry.
It's okay. You're choked up. We understand.
Me and him, we've been best friends since the second grade. And there was that time Coach Dan Winkle taught me how to win. We were racing up the rock wall at recess. Coach Dan Winkle got to the top at the same time I did. And Coach Dan Winkle had beat me several times, and that time I had both legs over before he did, and I thought he was going to let me win. You know what Coach Dan Winkle did?
Probably pushed you off the top of the rock.
He kicked me square in the chest and pushed me down to the wood chips below. And when he won that rock climbing contest, he came and he helped me up, and he said, come back if you ever want to try again.
Sounds like a coach.
Coach Dan Winkle. That's why we win today, Zach. Got to something else. I don't care. Got to something else.
In recent SSC videos, as you all know, Coach Dan Winkle has been slammed by the Silverback from the negligence of the Spank. And it's crazy to think because he was starting tailback for General Neyland. And he's been through 7 wars. And he was put in a jungle by himself with just a flip-flop and a toothpick. So I think we should all have a moment of silence for Coach Dan. But you know, I don't think the coach would want me to be sad like this, you know? So to get all that out of the way, AJ, I've been training. I've been training here at the ranch. So I will meet you in the squared circle.
One time, I went to my favorite food establishment.
McDonald's.
Mickey D's. And I got my normal order. 2 bacon McDoubles, no pickle, no mustard. McChicken, a large water, a 20-piece McNugget, and a chocolate shake, no whipped cream if they have the machine up and running, which at the time they don't. But, so I get that burger. I open it up, because you always got to check. You never know. There's always fishy people out there.
That's right.
Yes, there is.
You're one of them.
And there laid upon my sandwich was the 2 most various things I do not like in this world. Pickles. There was pickles on my burger!
You just both of them?
Yes!
Oh, man.
It's a travesty. What'd you do, Spank?
I didn't have to do anything. Because he came! He was there! He came! He was there! He jumped on the hood of my truck, snatched my pickles off of my burger, grabbed the pickles, threw them in the window, and said, "Hey! He didn't want no pickles. That's the man that stood up for me when I needed it."
Well,
that was certainly something.
That strange. Was. It sounds like something Coach Winkle would have done.
That's the type of man that Coach Dan Winkle was.
I agree.
Coach Dan Winkle.
Yes, I'm not giving up hope.
Coach Dan Winkle was the type of man that would take the pickle straight off of your burger and shove them in an unwilling drive-thru lady's eye. Just for the betterment of you and your dining experience.
My kids watch this show. Thank you for saying I.
You're welcome. Coach Dan Winkle was the type of man that would kick you off the rock wall just to make you a better winner.
That's right.
And Coach Dan Winkle was the type of man that would lead you up a mountain just to get you a second title shot.
Absolutely.
He's that type of man. And I like to not only relive the memories that no one talks about, but the memories we've seen here on SSC. And that's my favorite one. Here's to the climb.
Well, you stole mine, so now I have to think of something else. And I'm going to take you to a little bit after the climb, something we haven't
Come
seen on the SSC. Okay, so we all remember how much you struggled with the map.
Yes.
They never could hold it right side up. And, you know, I love you both, but I think we all know that me and the coach have a bit of a stronger relationship.
Yes, you do. I've always been jealous of it.
And he came to me, he confided in me, and he said, "Silverback, I can't read. I mean, he told me to never say this, but I think it is important in the woke culture we live in for this world to know that this man was man enough to admit to his insecurities."
Yes, he was.
"And since I have a wonderful degree in education bestowed on me by Tennessee Tech University, I sat that man down in my classroom. He learned to read, and not only did he learn to read, but he learned to read in 7 days. It's not like anything I've ever seen
before.
It takes
most people 12 years.
The brain power on that individual. I just... He's remarkable.
Yes, he is.
He's charming.
And I think...
He's handsome. He's hilarious. And speaking of people that are funny, let's toss to another clip from a loyal SSC subscriber.
If you saw last week's SSC video, subscribe, by the way, you would see Big Silverback chokeslam the Winkster. And I've been told the Winkster's in critical condition. And it's that no good Spank's fault. Spank blinded Big Stu's eyes with that flower. Now Spank, that belt you got, it's made you go mad with power. I think I'm going to be the one to do something about it. Now yes, I'm already wrestling at Coldfield. And you said you wanted the devil at Coldfield. So let me go talk to my dad to see if we can't get this match sanctioned.
What is this? What is this?
That's the captain. It's a very heartfelt message, is what it was.
In my time of mourning, you let him be a part of this?
Spanky, there were thousands of messages.
Coach Dan Winkle's gone. I'm trying to mourn here. I'm trying to summer the loss of a dear companion, a dear partner, a dear lover. And you bring him? Someone who I do not love. Someone who is not a partner. Someone who is not a friend. Someone who I hate.
Spanky, you just hate the kid because of his last name. And that's not right.
He's a fine young man. He grew our subscriber count immensely.
Look, I know I've never let y'all down. And I know...
You haven't... Continue, I'm sorry.
I can read shady people. I can't tell you why I can read shady people, but I know shady people when I see it. He is using us. He is using us. You know it. Hey, you know it.
Listen, be that as it may, there's no need to point the fingers at one another right now. We're supposed to come together during all of this. We're bonding, as you can see. Just... Maybe calm down?
Look, I can't calm down. I'm sick and tired of him. I'm sick and tired of his yellow pants. I'm sick and tired of his goofy smile. I'm sick and tired of his no-tail. I'm sick and tired of him riding rocket ship. I'm sick and tired of him trying to be relevant because of me.
Spanky.
And you brought him here.
I didn't bring him. He's not here, dum-dum.
You are supposed to be my friend.
Calm down.
So you know what, bearded one? It's days like this that I have something in my back pocket.
Okay.
I brought a friend.
Okay.
You know, a few of us were asked to send in videos for Coach Winkle. Poor Dan. Caught in the middle of all this nonsense. And if you've been keeping up with the SSC, then you know that all this is a bunch of nonsense. And it all revolves around one person. That's you, Zach. One thing after another. The stuff with Spanky. The incident with Kirk. And then this. All these people that you claim to be friends with, you keep hurting. And now, you've drug your brother into this. And you have a whole town of people fooled. You have a whole town of people willing to go to war with you any given night. Because they don't know the man you really are. And I'll admit it, for a long time, you had me fooled too. You had me fooled too, and you're probably asking yourself, why, JR, why? But it's simple. I had to get you before you could get me. And I know we got this big show coming up. You got Coalfield coming up. It's your hometown. And what better way to expose you? What better way to show everyone that loves you, that cheers for you, that cares, that buys tickets and packs that building every single time that you two are not the men that you pretend to be? It is all a facade. And what better person to do that than me? Make no mistake about it. The Zenith is coming to expose you.
I mean,
are we serious?
Is this what we're getting? He's about as real of a friend as you are, I guess.
Hey,
guys, we need to settle down.
No, I'm good. I'm just, whether it's August 5th or August 11th, he can get it. But you know what? Fair play.
We all need to settle down. Tensions are getting high, and I think we all need to calm down, because I've had all I can stand, and I haven't even got to mourn my best friend, and now we're calling it...
You know what?
Everyone calm down!
I think you've lost it.
Yes, I have!
You know, I just don't know if we're stable enough to do this.
No, I'm not stable!
I don't know if we're...
He's never been stable.
I don't know if we're just stable enough to do anything right now. You know what? I think this is it. I'm making the executive decision here. There will be no heartbeat. We must cancel Coalfield in memory of Coach Dan Winkle. We can't do this.
No!
We can't do...
Absolutely not, you fussle tuck duck!
What? Hey!
Calm down!
I love
everyone
this!
Everyone calm down!
I'm cool!
You know what?
I'm sick of
you! I'm sick of you!
I'm sick of you!
You almost killed me, but we're not killing the town. So you, and you, also you, get it together. We've got a wrestling show to run, and damn it, it's gonna go. Now get in here. Ah! Mom! Hello, Silverback. I can't see you, but I love you.
We're gonna do that.
That's right.
We're gonna do
we made it.
He's alive.
Get a hair, Major. Oh. Oh my God. That's right. I'll get that off my shoulder.